Hey guys, thank you for watching and listening to the Last Call Entertainment Podcast. We share with you great, fun, entertaining things and people's viewpoints, things from around the world. We have a very special guest here today, Tracy Dean.
You got it, yep.
It's not pronounced differently.
It's like James.
James.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
We're sitting
my
here.
Cousin.
Your cousin?
No. Sorry. Jimmy is, right?
Jimmy? Yeah. We're sitting here enjoying some Prosecco at Twist Bar Bistro Social. And how would you describe yourself? Why are you so special to you? I kind of asked you that in a different way, but now this is my honor.
Right, and we've had a little bit to drink.
Oh, right. We don't count the
honor in
other
order. Oh, right. We're not going to tell about that, those shocks, really.
What shocks?
Joking.
Thanks. So
appreciate
what,
it.
So, what makes you so special?
I don't know what makes me special, but what makes the relationship with, it sounds weird, relationship, whatever, our friendship with Kurt and myself,
and Twist, and the exchange. Because you'll be here next Thursday, I'm sure.
Yes, of course.
Me too. We might do this in one show.
Oh, okay.
I'd like to get everyone that's on the show to do a show after the show, like a quick 5 minutes.
Oh, cool.
Do the show, and then just go on stage.
Yeah, okay, I'll do it. So I met Kirk at actually Mayor Mendenhall's party, the event that she won.
Is that the picture?
Yeah.
I thought it was
her.
Oh,
that's not that night, though.
But that's her.
That is her.
Yeah. I thought it was her, but you guys have an answer.
Yeah.
Like, I think it's the mayor. I'll use that.
So you can't really tell, but the night that Kirk and I met was at the congratulations party. I can't think of what the name of that is. But anyway, and we just kind of hit it off. He was talking about who he was, the bar, and I mentioned I'm with the Utah LGBTQ Plus Chamber of Commerce. And the next thing was he wanted to be a part of the chamber and give back to the LGBT community. And that was really awesome to me because, you know, I work with a lot of different large businesses, and you know, they're not so quick to want to join. I mean, we joined quickly.
Oh, I see. That makes
sponsored sense. Our event, you know, after, you know, we had a next meeting. So
big businesses have to think about it, have a meeting, about a few meetings probably.
Yeah, yeah.
Decide, see if it's in the budget, maybe, right?
Yeah,
it's
right.
It's not really much, I don't think.
Right. It's,
I mean,
not
different commerces.
Yeah, so he's a corporate partner, which is our highest level of membership, and
yeah. That was for you, Kurt.
Yeah, he's not listening.
Yeah, he's focused.
He's busy. But yeah, so we just hit it off, and then we got to planning. Well, I was going to say the nice thing is coming off June, you know, Pride Month. So many corporations try to whitewash, or rainbow wash, I should say, their logos. Yeah, whitewash wasn't it. It was rainbow wash logos and just put up these Pride logos. But there's so much more to what businesses can be doing, employee resource groups, joining chambers of commerce, and really, I mean, Kirk gives back to the community, the LGBT community, in everything that we do. So we are excited to plan our second Days of 47 event here July 22nd through 24th.
Oh, cool. Yeah, yeah. I remember talking about that. I'll have to be here soon.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, for sure.
You'll see a lot of you around these things. We're opening the 9th, next week, next Thursday. It's exciting.
Yep, I'll be here. And, yeah, this year is nice because it's not the pandemic.
What pandemic?
We had bandanas. There's some hanging over there, and that's what we wore.
Oh yeah, right.
That's what we wore.
Is that where they retired?
Yeah, they need to be retired.
I know. Right?
Yeah, yeah.
Well,
sure.
Let's not go into all that. Well, let's move forward. You could ask, what was the impact on the LGBTQ+ community from the pandemic?
I mean, you know, just like everyone else, you know, small businesses suffered. A lot of them, you know, like your first position or other restaurants and bars that are part of the chamber, you know, they had to close, obviously, as we all know. But part of our work with the chamber and with Sully County is we have funds and people available that are helping the small businesses in recovery stage. So anything from helping them apply for loans or get funding and marketing and business plans, accounting, whatever it is, that's what we're doing now with small businesses. So it was impactful, just like any other business, really.
Yeah. Just like anyone else. That's a good answer. I like that. Just like anyone else, Adam.
Oh, yeah.
Adam. Just like anyone else, Adam. I'll be like, oh, crap.
The one thing that we do have, and small business owners that are LGBT owned, you know, we also have this kind of desire to help out in other ways with the community, and suicide prevention, up at the Capitol when they're talking about, you know, hurting trans kids and things like that. And so as a business owner, you have all those responsibilities. And then also there's a lot of civil and social responsibilities that I think we carry as well. So it exacerbates that issue. So
yeah, I guess that's what I meant when I asked that question, is that it seems like there'd be more socially. It seems to be harder.
Yeah.
You have to deal with more crap.
Yeah, more crap.
Oh,
more shit.
More shit. You throw more shit from people, and some of it you don't see, right? Because I deal with racism a little bit. I'm really Eastern born here in America, and I know that's different, but I deal with a little bit, but a lot of it comes to the community.
So
you have to go, is that guy racist? Or is that girl? Or is that group?
Yeah.
Because you wonder, like, everything seems fine, what else could it be?
Or is that unless non-binary I was an asshole. Person? Racist. You said guy and girl.
Yeah, the non-binary, they.
Yeah, you got it.
But exactly, and thank you for that. But exactly, so what do you do with that? Do you see that or not see that sometimes?
Just
that kind of impact?
Yeah, absolutely. Fighting for equal rights and you know, everything from, there was just a lawsuit about another flower person not wanting to, you know, do bouquet for some a gay person's wedding. And I think I've read that just today,
yeah,
and I'm like,
there's
another one today. It's interesting. So that's what's so cool about the chamber is we're LGBT and ally business owners. Obviously, Kurt is an ally. He has an amazing wife, Brandy. What part do you know
her? I met her once or twice.
And but so for us, we really are sort of this family that comes together, like-minded individuals, whereas other places that we go, especially in Utah, is, you know, you can feel like it's the good old boys club or something where you just don't fit in, and your business kind of suffers for that because the networking that we have, I mean, so many people propel their business because of the chamber. It's awesome to see. There's also a certification. Did you know that, Adam?
Nope.
There's thanks. There's we're a member of the National LGBTQ. Actually, it's the National LGBT Chamber of Commerce, which is the NGLCC, and they have. So that's the national chamber, NGLCC, National Gay Lesbian Chamber. It's what it used to stand for. But they are the regulatory body to get LGBT business owners certified. And so you have women-owned, veteran-owned, minority-owned businesses that can help, you know, contracts. I can't ever say that word. Procure contracts with Fortune 500 companies. That's one of them. But to get contracts with these larger companies, there is now an LGBT certification group, which is called Business Enterprise.
Oh, good.
And so if you're 51% or greater LGBT owned, you can get certified. And so that's what we try to do with the chamber too, is help businesses get certified. Because why not? Help your business.
So can you share a bit, since you shared it, with me, when your life changed and why you made a shift and became such an advocate for the community?
Sure. I had two life shifts. I don't think you know the second one, Adam. But the first
Maybe I don't.
You don't. I'm sure I didn't either. So the first one, I was in an ejection car accident. We rolled 10 times and I was ejected from the car and I died on the scene. That was almost 21 years ago. And I really kind of had to take an introspective look at where my life was heading and what I wanted to be when I grew up. I was 23 at the time. That's going to age. But anyway,
if
you can do math.
The way I say years ago, I always make it.
I know. I already said 21, so that kind of screwed it up. But anyway, so I moved back to Salt Lake. I was the first in my family to graduate college from Westminster, and I majored in business finance. So my day job is my financial advisor. So I help people. I saw what insurance did for me, health, disability, and not life insurance, but how important it is to have that foundation.
Oh, I see. So you saw it as a positive.
Yeah.
Because a lot of people, I know, it might, of course, but some people see it as
negative.
Right,
got it. Right? Yeah. So,
and I fought with insurance companies for my dad.
Great.
To the point I was like, I'm healthy now, it's healthy then. I was like, okay, I'm not dealing with secondary insurance. I'm not dealing with this.
Right.
I'm just going to pay for it out of pocket because it's actually less stressful.
Totally.
Because they're supposed to pay. We're not,
The whole
run around. It's hours.
Yeah, luckily, I couldn't walk or talk, and so my mom had to deal with all that.
Insurance helped you?
Yeah, because I would have had, to date, have about $750,000 in medical bills. So I had medical disability, or I had health insurance at the time. I had disability insurance. I couldn't walk for a year, which means I couldn't work.
You can walk now. Congratulations.
Pretty good.
Some
bars and screws.
Oh, yeah, that's great.
Yeah, thank you.
You're talking, doing most of the talking, which is normal on the podcast.
Okay.
So I'm drinking.
I like to share.
And we have a shot.
All right.
Hope the shot. You brought up the shot.
You really do have shots.
Okay. Yeah, we snuck behind the bar.
We didn't.
I need those shots. So, insurance means if it's good luck for you.
Right. And so then I graduated. Well, I'll fast forward a little bit because this is only like about half an hour of podcast.
Do you want to talk longer? Or can we start before you?
I don't think so. I think
we can go 45 minutes.
I know people want to hear from me.
We need another break.
Because I'm like a celebrity.
Look, we don't have to extend the show for you get another break.
Oh,
okay.
I just hear it twist. I just have to look in the eye.
Oh, I got
someone,
it. You're like,
and they know what I want.
She has a regular drink, which she didn't get because I was like, the Prosecco looks good.
And I just went along with that.
So,
we digress.
Well, that's
good.
That's
okay.
We're trying to be insurance.
Oh.
This is for me.
Okay.
Insurance.
Back then.
You couldn't walk for a year. You're still in medical bills.
And so then I was the first in my family to graduate college. And that's what I started saying is graduating in finance, started working in the insurance industry. And that was phenomenal. Now I do, work on that insurance foundation and then build up the sexier assets, and investing is what I focus on now. And then sexier. Yeah, it's sexier than insurance, don't you think? Investing? ETFs and mutual funds and stocks.
I own some Dogecoin.
Oh.
I own some Bitcoin, too. Yeah.
I do, too, but when did you buy it?
The Dogecoin has gone down, and so has the Bitcoin has gone down a lot. But I actually bought it when it was lower, than it is now.
Oh.
But it's sad to see it go. I remember it was 57,000.
Yeah.
Now it's 37,000.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
I guess sexy has something to do with this.
Yes.
The insurance you don't really think it's this.
It's the antithesis of this, right?
Yeah.
The opposite of this. But I promise this will tie into the chamber in just a second. So then I heard about this Utah, actually, it's the Utah Gay and Lesbian Chamber of Commerce 6 years ago. And I joined the board because I don't know how to do anything half-assed. So I was quickly
on.
I didn't join as a member. I joined as a board member. So that's how I do things.
Good.
So, and then 4 years ago, I was voted in as chairwoman of the chamber. And so then my two worlds intersected. That's what I put my form to. My two worlds intersected, but it took a lot for my partner to come out and to be out in the world. It took a lot for my family to accept that. So the interesting thing about being part of the chamber was just that, being part of an LGBT organization was a really big thing for me.
So it was going on when you had the experience. You had your partner for a long time. Have you seen how the world has changed then? Has that helped your relationship? The world has changed.
Yeah, so we haven't. So back then I was with a male, and he's the one that wrecked the car. So we don't talk about him. But yes, I mean, for sure. Our timeline for that, you know, I'm 6 years in the chamber. And so that was a little bit fast-forwarded to where we are now, but we're 15 years happy together, and that's what I, you know, the intersection of the chamber and my business has been wonderful. It's been great. I get to meet awesome people like Adam.
Well,
like
the show's not over yet.
Oh.
So you don't know.
Oh, right. You could still be mean to me?
I'm not mean. I'm never mean.
He said he could be mean to me.
I'm never mean.
You said that.
I didn't say mean. I
hope
said,
I don't offend you.
I don't offend you or offend anyone else. Or, but I'm never mean unless I'm joking. I'm very nice.
Close to the bear.
Oh, yeah. And then it's like my New Yorker, I'm illegal, all of it comes out.
We're sitting way too close for that shit. It's really hot in here, huh?
Oh, now.
Now
she says it's hot. Earlier, she was like, oh, it's fine. What's your problem?
I'm not going to.
It could be the we're doing a show.
Oh.
Like, I do stand up comedy, and I'm actually doing a show on Tuesday nights.
Oh, here?
Once a month at Exchange.
Oh, yeah.
And it was easier the seventh time I did it, which was last week. But each time I do some other kind of public speaking, and I spoke and I was screaming at myself because I was nervous. I didn't like time myself right. I'm like, what is your problem? You speak all the time publicly, right?
Yeah.
It was so good.
Yeah, well, I'm not nervous to say no.
So what is the day before we say what is coming?
Did you say days? It's gays.
Oh,
gays.
I'm sorry. I said it. Well, I said it the other way.
I know. That's see. Now you got it. Now you understand it. Yeah. That was Kirk's idea, though, not mine. I won't take. Sorry. I won't. Yeah.
He's like Kirk. I heard my name.
I won't take credit for that one. So the gays of 47 is just a dang good time. So some people in Utah celebrate July 24th. Utah became a state for out-of-state people. I keep having to explain this one.
Oh, that's what we're explaining. I forgot.
Oh,
I forgot.
Already.
You know, the pandemic blanked my brain out.
Oh.
So I forgot 4th of July was this year. Oh, yeah, it is the 4th of July.
That's because you don't do any fireworks. So it's...
Can they?
I think, well, like, like, or public. Yeah. But anyway.
I don't know, some people can be crazy.
So the other play on words is Pie and Beer Day. You know that one?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, it's some people aren't from Utah, so I literally have to run through this whole dichotomy with them.
I'm not from Utah. I've been here long
enough.
But you
know.
Yeah, I forgot about the days of 47.
But now it's the gays.
So what is it?
The gays. It's when the gays come to Twist 3 days. Every gay person in the state of Utah. And if you're in somewhere far away, you can stay at my house. Just joking. There's a hotel.
Our address is 1785. It'd be funny if there was an address.
Yeah, I grew up in eight. Yeah, not even close. No, there's several awesome hotels. Okay, so we have drag queens coming. The Exchange will be open, which is next door.
There's a drag queen show every Thursday.
Thursday. I don't know. Why did you just put me on the spot? I don't know.
Sometime in the evening, there is
LGBT nights every Thursday.
There you go. Come early.
Yeah, you should come early. But during Gays of 47, there'll be periodic times of the drag shows. Kurt might not like me saying this, but we're trying.
He's been kind of some funny faces.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's just the way he is, or he hears us, he goes, oh.
I'm trying to convince him to get a mechanical bull.
Oh, that'd be cool.
That also wasn't my idea, but I squashed it last year because of the pandemic. I was like,
you can't get close to the bull.
Yeah.
Oh, you're over that. That's cool. So you were staunch about it.
Well, yeah, because it was the pandemic.
Germs are fine.
We wanted to
just
party.
Exchange all your, about to pour your drink in my drink. Yeah, forget about it.
Well, I'm vaccinated, so.
Everybody's
you
vaccinated.
You can choose to drink it or not. I don't think so. I don't think everyone's vaccinated. Because Spencer coughs.
That was slightly my sarcastic.
Okay.
The mechanical bowl.
I think it was really more the insurance. How much is the insurance?
I mean, you can get liability.
I mean, I work in insurance with
different lines. Oh, yeah, you should.
I have liability
insurance. Good. So, if like,
if I hit you?
In show. No, it's for my, I have a line of something.
Good.
So, $300 a
week. That's awesome.
It's like, who cares?
So we're gonna close off the Exchange Place, the circle out there. I mean, I guess the city still needs to permit it, but we've got the application in. And then the drag shows, everything queer and gay will be here. Decorations. Liquor companies gives us swag. Well, gives him swag. I say us because a lot of people around here think I'm in control of this place, but I'm not. But to those of you that are watching that think I am. The life thinks I'm in control. He's handed down our exchange.
Oh, can you tell us what it is?
The Exchange is a hip new. I'm not very hip or new. So it's a hip place for young people to go. But no, really, it's not. And LGBT night every Thursday.
Anyone older over 28, you're killing them all.
Well, you know, that's because I go to bed at like 8:30. So
I don't believe
not that. Every night.
Because these guys wouldn't know you.
I come here at 5.
Yeah.
Ask them. But for reals, though. It is going to be Utah's swankiest club, I am certain of it, because I did help design. You know what I did?
No,
just occurred to me.
Tell us all.
Okay, when we were walking the space, Kirk had, okay, here's where the bathrooms are, and I go, hold on, do we have gender-neutral bathrooms?
Oh, good. Yeah.
And he, guess what he said?
No.
No. And I said,
that was a hard guess.
Oh no.
No.
This is not how this is going down. So he has closets now. That's when closes. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. That's awesome. I've walked
through it. I should put my name on
a couple months ago. I did a tour, actually.
Dedicated by...
Oh, there you go.
Tracy.
We'll just make a plaque.
Yes.
And then when you're here, just...
Do I want to be part of a bathroom?
Hey, it's better be part of a bathroom than nothing.
Okay. I may not have to think about that one.
Yeah, I don't.
I have to think about that one.
You see, that's one of those jokes.
Like, and it didn't offend me, so
okay,
that's good.
So what
it's
else can you tell?
Basically
called
shit.
What
else? Bathroom.
No, you went there. Bathrooms can be, could be something. Yeah. A bathroom could be like a good crying. They do drugs.
Well, they
drink.
That's how you're associating me still. Crying and drugs?
Sex. I said sexy.
I'm ending this.
I said sexy. Okay.
I'm ending this. Podcast.
You can walk it off. I'll be the first. I'll be your first. It'll be fun. I'll be like, no.
Throw his microphone
Success.
Away. But no. So I grew up in Utah. I did live in San Diego when I was in the car accident, but no one really needs to know that for me to get the story out. But there were clubs like Habits too. Wait, did you live here when Habits was around? There's a club like Habits, was on 33rd, and that was where everyone got dressed up, and you know, we get dressed up and have a really fun time, and
nice.
We have bottle service and VIP lounges,
VIP lounges.
All the hottest DJs, and where you want to catch a guy or a gal or a non-binary pal.
Non-binary pal, I like that.
Also not my... Jake almost just walked in front of us.
Ha! It'll be funny. Do it. Just replace my phone.
Anyway, so it'll be the place where you want to be seen. So I'm super excited about it.
Yeah,
even though I'll just be here Thursdays. Everyone should come every night that they're open. Every night.
Right now it's... Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
Oh, okay.
Good
to know.
And once a month, Tuesday.
Is that
who knows?
Wait.
That's a comedy.
Oh, that's your night? Are you that funny?
Not really.
I might have to
check. You should come. Can you do
stand-up? Well, let's do it together.
We can do it.
I don't.
We can do a skill.
Okay.
I could act like the, I don't even want to say
Middle Eastern
or
from New York?
No.
I mean, that's not funny. See, now I can offend you.
You could offend
me. I'm
not
going to.
That's my show. Let's not do that. So tell us about, in closing, tell us about your viewpoint about how we can help Utah be more diverse.
That's a wonderful question. Thank you for asking. So we... The LGBT chamber lives because there is a demand for diversity in the state of Utah. And growing up here, you know, I grew up in Sandy, and I was just telling the story today. You know, I had a graduating class of 1,000. In my entire school, there was, you know, a handful of black people. And so, but now, fast forward to today, we partner with the Black Chamber, the Pacific Islander Chamber, Hispanic, the Suazo Business Center is awesome, and the Asian Chamber. So Suazo is a Hispanic, they mainly help Hispanic business owners get started and anything business-wise. But so, yeah, we partner with all the diversity, we call them diversity chambers. I don't know if you've ever heard that term, because we're not located geographically. The entire university. And so we really are, we got together, we formed Living Color Utah, and to show that there is diversity in Utah. And it's getting better. I mean, you know, several people are moving here and feeling that we do have some diversity. You know, it's changing, and it's the work that we do, that these other groups do, that's making it possible. That could be a slip of the tongue by the Prosecco.
Oh, slip of the tongue.
Left that.
Oh, fluff left? I didn't even
know
this. Because I have Prosecco too.
Yeah. It was a fluff left.
You notice how you have to, like, if you show up to the party and someone's been there for a bit and they have, like, several drinks?
Oh,
you're like, you're not understanding, you're like, oh, I don't know.
Yeah.
I can understand what's going on.
Why but
are
these
people having so much fun? Yeah.
Yeah, but we're the same.
We're
so
the same.
Worry.
We're all the same, right?
Yeah.
Well,
thank
you for
but different.
Different, same. So thank you for being on the show, Tracy. Appreciate it. So, Gays of 47, what are the dates?
July 24th, or 22nd through 24th.
22nd through 24th, that's a weekend, I think.
Yep, Saturday is the 24th, so that'll
nice.
Be big.
Good, good. And then the exchange opens up on the 9th, Thursday, with the drag show. Can you tell us anything about the drag show?
Jason Cosmo is starring in the drag show. They are an amazing performer, super fun. They actually, we did a show just for the exchange. So I haven't even seen it.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, that's
nice.
That's
or maybe not.
Yeah.
Maybe you should have seen
well,
it first.
That's a good point. So.
Wait, no.
That's a good point. I better work on that. But anyways.
We're done on there.
Well, it's a good thing, huh?
Yeah, the timing is perfect, but we're not done on here. So thank you guys for listening to the show. Keep your eyes and ears out for our next show at Blue Boutique, Thursday at 5 o'clock. We'll also have a surprise show either before or after that at the Last Call Entertainment Studio. And we'll be sharing about the Incandescent Festival. And who knows, we might throw a show or two your way. Thank you guys. See ya.
Later.
Yeah, so we're done, but for some reason we lost the connection. So I think, you know, it was good timing. So how was that for you?